All right. The other part of the circuit is what we're going to be focusing on now, and that is this era. We already learned how this era came about. All right, so the first thing we're going to be looking at here is this clock. The clock is very important because the clock is like the heartbeat of the microcontroller. What the clock actually does, it sends a pulse every time at every interval of time, it could be, sometimes it sends up to 1 million pulses in a second. Sometimes it can send 32,000 pulses in a second. Whatever amount of pulses in a second it sends is what determines the frequency of the clock. In this case, it's a 4 megahertz clock, so it's 4 million pulses that it sends into the microcontroller every second. What do those pulses do? The pulse is very simple. At any time the microcontroller gets a pulse, it does something. Anytime it gets a pulse, it does something. So if you remove the clock, as you will see in the when we're building the circuit, if you remove the clock, when we're testing the circuit, you will see that when we remove the clock, the microcontroller will stop wherever it is. That is where it will stop. Once you remove the clock, it will stop wherever it is. And when you put the clock back, it will continue from where it stopped. Because the clock is like what tells it to move forward, to make progress. So, being a 4 million pulses per second clock, it means that this controller, ideally, is supposed to be executing instructions. It's supposed to be executing 4 million instructions every second. But that is not really the case for some reasons that are beyond the scope of this course. But for now, just know that you have to connect the clock to the microcontroller. And they already told you, the manufacturer already told you that the clock should be connected to pin 9 and 10. So that is not your business. You just connect the clock to pin 9 and 10 and everything is just supposed to work. Alright, the next thing we're going to go to is the power supply, which is the battery. We're using a 9-volt battery here, and this is the negative side of the battery, while this is the positive side of the battery. The microcontroller needs power to do what you are telling it to do, and it uses 3 pins. This particular controller uses 3 pins for power supply. It uses pin 8 and pin 19 as its ground, and uses pin 20 as its positive or its 5-volt supply. All right, so which means pin 8 and 19 are internally connected in the circuit of the microcontroller, and pin 8 and 19 go to the same place. You can actually just connect them together and take only one wire here, but I decided to take the two wires directly to this point for simplicity so that you can easily understand. They go to the same place and they both go to ground, because this is the ground of my controller. The next is pin 20 and pin 1. First of all, let's start with pin 20. Pin 20 is the power, like the that's where 5 volt enters. That's where the positive of my controller is. So it is rated at 5 volts. The controller does not like voltages above 5 volts. And it works best with voltages within above 4 volts and less than between 4 to 5 volts, but maximum of 5 volts, that is what it can work with. So we use 5 volts regulator, 5 volt, we use a 5 volt regulator to provide that 5 volts to my controller. And this particular type of regulator we use is called a 7805. As the name implies, that 5 there means that it is bringing out 5 volt from this particular pin. This is the output pin, it brings out 5 volt from here. Where does it get the voltage from? Because we have 9 volt here, how does it change 9 volt to 5 volt? It is simple. Inside this regulator, there is a very complex circuit that even makes it possible for it to take 9 volts and then bring out only 5 volts and nothing more than 5 volts. The highest you can bring out is 5.1, and it takes that voltage and sends it to pin 20 of the microcontroller, and everything works very well. But before the 7805 regulator can work, you have to connect its ground pin as well to ground. Before this 7805 regulator can work, you have to connect its ground pin to ground, once again to the battery negative. Then you connect the input to the battery positive. Even if this battery voltage falls to 8 volts, we'll still be getting 5 volts here, because the voltage regulator regulates the voltage coming out from here to the 5 volts that they put here. If there is a 7809 regulator, it will be 9 volts that will come out from here, but you have to give it higher than 9 volts before it can give you 9 volts. In this case, we're giving it far, far higher than 5 volts, which is 9 volts here. And that's why it's able to give us constant 5 volts. My controller does not like varying voltage, so we need something that will give us a constant 5 volts, and that's why we need the voltage regulator. The last thing here is this 10k resistor here. What does it do? It's simple. This is the MCLR pin of my controller. It is a very, very important pin. Why do I say so? If you remember in the old, if you remember many years ago, when I was a student, there were calculators that we bought in market that when the calculator hangs, when you type some very complex mathematical expression, calculator will just hang and you will not know what to do. You will be pressing off, it will not move off. So what we'll do, we take a pen, and then there's one small hole behind the calculator that we'll press that pen into. And when we press the pen, everything will reset, and then we can now continue our work with the calculator. That pin that we used to press in those days is actually the MCLR pin of the microcontroller that was inside that calculator. I'm sure you now know what this MCLR pin does. It is the pin of the microcontroller that detects something. When a particular voltage gets into it, it will reset the entire system. It will reset itself. It will reset everything once a particular voltage gets in, and that voltage is a ground voltage. If this ground here should by mistake get to the microcontroller reset pin, everything that it is doing will be suspended and reset. So, but you now ask, since we didn't connect the pin to the ground, so isn't it not just enough for us to not connect the pin to the ground and everything will work well? Well, you can do that, you can try that, and you see the result. But from my experience, the truth is, if you don't pull up that particular pin to a high voltage, noise can send a low voltage, which is an unwanted signal. An unwanted low signal can go into that pin and then cause the microcontroller to reset when it is doing something very important. And we don't want that to happen. So we have to pull this pin 1 up to 5 volts.